Jesus spoke to me. I have signed your pardon.
Oh, sing that again, brother.
You may now go free. I was in sin's prison, oh, so dark and cold. Just a lost sheep wandering from God's eternal fold. Then the door swung open. Jesus spoke to me. You may now go free.
Amen.
Jesus signed my pardon. This I surely
know. Do you know it, church?
He took my place.
Amen.
At Calvary. Now I don't have to go. All my life I'll give him. He gave his for me. When he signed my pardon. My Savior led me from that awful place. I can hear the angels as they sing Amazing Grace. I knew that I was pardoned from my sin and shame. Then I joined the angels singing glory to His name.
Oh, think about it, church.
Oh, Jesus signed my pardon. This I surely know. Took my place at Calvary. Now I don't have to go. All my life I'll give him. He gave his for me. When he signed my pardon there at Calvary. Life is now worth living since I've been set free. To know that he was willing to save a wretch like me. Not a prison wall. Since he signed my pardon and he paid it all. Life is now worth living since I've been set free. To know that he was willing to save a wretch like me. Now I have a mansion, not a prison wall. Since he signed my pardon and he paid it all. Jesus signed my pardon. This I surely know. He took my place at Calvary. Now I don't have to go. All my life I'll give him. He gave his for me. When he signed my pardon there at Calvary.
Hallelujah. Aren't you glad that Jesus signed your pardon?
Amen.
Hallelujah. The debt was great. But Jesus said, it is finished. Amen.
Amen.
Paid in full. Paid with the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. We are here to worship this great God today. Amen. We thank God for Jesus Christ. We thank God that he paid the price at Calvary for you and for me. Amen. I want to welcome you to the Grandview Church of God this morning. We are delighted to have each and every one of you. We are delighted to have the Hendrix Trio with us today. Would you give the Lord a hand clap offering? Amen. They are always special, been always special to this church. Amen. We remember the years when the Jenkins sisters would come and bless us. And now the baton's been handed to the Hendrix Trio. And we just thank God for them, and we're looking forward to a wonderful time in the Lord this morning. I want you to clap as hard as you can and get as excited as you can for the Hendrix Trio. Come and minister and have your way in the Lord with us. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Oh,
words that didn't matter. All she knew was Jesus she had to see. So she took her box made of alabaster, poured the oil on the feet of the Master. And I'm sure if we had been there, we would have heard her say,
I came to worship you, to lift your name on high, and with all my heart, with you I glorify. I give honor where honor is due. I came to worship you.
Now I too was once a sinner, but to Jesus that didn't matter. He looked beyond my faults, saw what I could be. I was worthless and so lost, but for me Jesus paid all the cost. Now all I am and all I have, I owe to Him. I give worship You, lift Your name on high, and with all my heart, it's You I glorify.
Losing sleep, but you can kneel on me.
moment you've been threatened away. Because you've got time to worry. You've got time to pray.
I'm so thankful that he tells us in Philippians chapter 4 that we don't have to be anxious for anything, but we can take everything to the Lord in prayer. Amen.
Hendricks Trail kind of had a short night last night. We Last Sunday morning, we were up in McKinleyville, California. And that is up north in the Redwoods. It is beautiful up there. We've had every gambit of the weather. It rained and snowed and sleeted and had to run the air conditioner. I'm serious. It was all within 30 miles, it seemed like. So we brought back some of those allergens from California, rebuked the devil, and came on. And prayed a whole lot along the way. We are so, so thankful to be back. So thankful to see all of y'all. How many of you have never met our family? Let me see your hands. There's some of you that are new since last time we were here, so I'll introduce us quickly. My husband, last Monday we celebrated 35 years.
Yeah. God should be good to us. Amen. Wonderful to be here. This young lady does most of the talking on stage because she can forevermore handle it.
I'm kin to the Jenkins sisters.
They all these talkers. It's sure good to be here. And her name is Rhonda. You can make her welcome this morning.
I'm a little bit under the weather this morning. And so I told Renessa, you better be ready to preach and testify and do whatever. So she's gonna take it over this morning till the Lord does. But I wanted to introduce our daughter, has been all of her 30 years, and she's still traveling with mom and dad. She's still single. We don't have a roadie yet. So if y'all want to have y'all have kin folks that wants to apply, we'd love to do it. If it's Lord's will.
Yes.
If his name's Will, we'll look at him too. You can make her welcome. Her name is Renessa.
Oh, I'm so thankful to feel the presence of the Lord in here this morning. Amen.
Yes.
I was thinking about this next song and trying to figure out what I needed to say this morning. And I can just tell you from personal experience that I've been in the lowest of lows, in dark depression that was so bad, I had no emotion on my face. And I've also been on the greatest of mountains, and the joy of the Lord filled my soul. But no matter where I was, there was Jesus.
Amen.
No matter what I was going through, there was Jesus.
Yes.
And I just want to remind you this morning and encourage you this morning that no matter what you're facing, He is there with you. I have known the peace that passes all understanding.
Yes.
Yes. And to be in His presence is the greatest joy of my life.
Yeah.
There was Jesus. Thank you.
don't feel like doing. I feel like this lady right here.
Yes, you.
I feel like you need to come right up here. And anybody else that wants a special touch this morning, you're welcome to come. I know we just got started, but when the Spirit is moving, we need to involve ourselves with the Spirit, because He is the only thing that's going to help us to make it. And if you want to make it to Lord, this morning is the day. And I want you, Lord Jesus. I thank you, Father.
Thank you. There's some of you carrying around diseases.
God wants you to walk away out of here clear.
Hallelujah.
Why do we come to church? Is it a social hour? We come because we believe that God changes. Prayer changes. Jesus changes things.
Hallelujah.
We believe that, do we not? That's why you have this feeling. Hendricks Trail just come in here and we're just the conduit this morning. And you can receive whatever. And I'm sorry if you are going through those things. I really am the loss. I know the loss of a loved one. I know those things may not be working out, but if you'll hold on. I believe Jesus is about to split the clouds. And I believe he's about to take us out of here. And you may be a scoffer and say, I've heard that all my life, but I can tell you one thing, you ain't never seen it like it's been lately. And when all these people are over there bumping at Israel, you might as well hold on to your pew. Because you may not go up if he does come. You know, without a shadow of a doubt, that God is about to see Jesus back. We all feel that. And this morning the preacher said, what's going to be shaken will be shaken. So I'm asking you to make sure that you're holding on to the vine of Jesus Christ. Hard and steady. Young people, you don't want to go to hell. You want to go to heaven. But if you're not holding on to the strong arm of Jesus Christ, you will not make it. We must be strong in Jesus. Knowing of him is not enough. Knowing him personally is enough. He's where the joy is. Yes, he is. Well, I have no idea what to do now. If you were a preacher, what would you do, Brother Aguilar? You know what? It's like I can feel the Spirit wanting to do something else. And I can feel the Spirit calling hearts. And you may not realize a tug on your... I see your faces, you see. I'm up here. I can see your faces. I can see if you look like that you're happy in your relationship or not, whether it's the one beside you or not. That sometimes will put a frown on your face, especially if you fussed all the way to church. Bobby and I have heated moments of fellowship in 35 years. Sometimes you will.
Usually over the GPS.
Oh, yes. The first time we turned that thing on, she said, turn right. And I'm thinking, I know that. I'm in my driving, my driveway. I know how to get out of here. How many of y'all love the GPS? It's just, I just have to sanctify it every time. I use one map and he uses another. It's a miracle we get in.
But she uses RSS. Rhonda says so.
Be nice. I gave her leeway to do everything she wanted to this morning because I wasn't feeling very good. But I can tell you one thing, I've been touched.
Hallelujah.
I've been touched. If it's okay, let us sing maybe one or two more songs. Is that okay with y'all? Yes. We are in the process of, and I will say this. I usually don't do this in a church service, and I'm real bad about it, but y'all won't know unless I tell you. We're in the process of recording a new project, and most of the songs that you've heard here this morning are on that CD, except the ones where I just took off singing. We had no idea what was coming next. Sometimes I wonder too. What's coming next? But I'm so thankful that if I'm around a hot stove, I recognize that it's hot. You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
And if I'm in a cold, freezing temperature, I recognize that I'm cold.
Yes.
And Lord, help me to to warm up to the Holy Ghost fire. To keep it inside until it comes. Well, choose you something, baby. Let's sing. Now, how about we sing something older? You want to do that? Got a song on your heart? Brother Bobby, you're supposed to be testifying. Why don't you testify and I'll find us something on this here new machine.
I appreciate the Lord, and He's sure been good to us. I love what I feel in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
He knows that He knows what we have need of before we know ourselves. And I'm so thankful that I serve a God that's that way.
Amen.
This song talks about faith. You know, some people see the mountain. They just look at the mountain. Or they look at the wall that's before them. They can't see anything beyond that. But faith sees the mountain move. Faith sees us going through. Amen. Only faith can see.
Trust and obey. there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Say it again. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. We love you guys.
Amen. Boy, isn't God good?
Amen.
Amen. Have you been blessed today?
Amen.
Praise God. I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. I needed a touch this morning. Amen. And I'm happy to report to you the Holy Ghost touched me. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Give the Lord a hand clap offering in this place. Glory to God. Amen. I want to brag on my brother and sisters. Amen. Do you notice their message? Their message is all about Jesus. They never put the spotlight on themselves. They put the spotlight on the only one that deserves the spotlight. His name is Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. I love what they do. They go all over America singing about Jesus, magnifying the Lord Jesus Christ. They're full of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. We need more musicians like that in America. Amen. We need more men and women like them that go and have a ministry that just points to the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And I thank God for them, and I want them to be successful. I want them to do this for many, many, many more years. And I think that what the Holy Ghost wants us to do is to partner with them. Amen. And I want our ushers to come and be prepared to take up an offering for our brother and sister, amen, and sisters. And I want to tell you something. What they do is not easy. What they do is not easy. They leave the comfort of their home and stay all over America, sometimes in uncomfortable situations, all for the glory of God, all for the glory of God. So I want you to dig deep this morning. And let me just tell you, the first number that comes to your mind will probably be the Holy Ghost. The second number that comes to your mind will probably be the devil. Amen. Trying to counteract what Holy Spirit put in your heart. But I want you to dig as deep as possible. I want you to bless them. You know, the Bible says the laborer is worthy of his hire. Amen. And we need to bless them. And then let me go ahead and say this before we take up the offering. I know my sister's in the very back, and they have a lot of material, a lot of their CDs, a lot of their music that they sell. I want us to buy it completely out. Amen. I want that when they leave, there's not a single CD left on that little rack. Amen. Go back there and spend money. My goodness, we spend money on the foolishness of Hollywood. We spend money, you know, sending money to people that hate God. And here we have people that love the Lord Jesus Christ. And I want us to give. Amen. Father, we thank you today for my brother and sisters, Lord. God, we thank you for the ministry, Lord, that you've given them. Lord, let them know this morning that we have been blessed because of them, Lord. And God, we just pray, Lord, that as we give, Lord, unto their ministry, that you would use this money, Lord, to further the kingdom of God through them. Lord, I pray, God, that you would help us to be partners in the kingdom of God, to further the gospel of Jesus Christ all around the world, my Lord. And God, we magnify you today, and we pray in the precious and beautiful name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Well, I have been blessed. Amen. Has anybody else been blessed today?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You know what I love about the Lord? He knows exactly what he's doing. Amen. He knows exactly what he's doing. He brings my brother and sisters up here, and they have the same exact spirit that we have, don't they? Amen. Same exact spirit that we have, and they love the Lord with all their heart. And I'm just so grateful that they're here with us this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, we preachers, we need to be refreshed too. Amen. And it feels good to just sit there and receive. Amen. It feels good to sit there and receive. And I have received this morning. God has blessed me. Amen. Hallelujah. Would you stand to your feet in the house of God? We're going to pray to dismiss this service. And then right afterwards, I want as many people as possible to come and hug their necks and tell them how much they blessed you. Encourage them. Tell them that they mean a lot to the Grandview Church of God. Amen. This is a highlight of every year when we have them here. We see them as a jewel to the Grandview Church of God. Father, we just thank you for today, my Lord. Thank you for my brothers and sisters, Lord. They have encouraged us. Lord, they have used, Lord, the ministry that you've given them to lift us up, Lord, to draw us closer to you, Lord Jesus. And God, I pray, encourage them today to remind them, Lord, that the work that they do is not in vain. Remind them, Lord, that one of these days they're going to be recompensed, Lord, for every mile that they've traveled for your glory, dear God. And Lord, as we depart from this place, Lord, we pray that your hand would be upon them. Lord, we pray that you protect them, Lord, to their next destination and bring them back. Lord, at the next appointed time that we could rejoice with them. And Lord, should the rapture of the church happen before then, we look forward to seeing them in the kingdom of heaven where we'll rejoice forevermore. And we pray tonight, this morning, in the mighty and powerful and beautiful name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen. Amen. God bless you, church.